In the 9.9 release, ActiveIQ Unified Manager supports snapshot-based backup and restore of Unified Manager database when using Windows iSCSI LANs. Backup and restore of Unified Manager database mounted on NFS on Linux using NetApp snapshot copies was introduced in the 9.8 release. This has been extended to Windows when using iSCSI LANs. By default, the Unified Manager backup method is MySQL-based backups. These backups were found to be inefficient and often took too long for backing up and restoring the data. But with snapshot-based backup, you can take backup in a very less time, usually a few minutes, and the space taken for the backup is very little. In the same way, restoring of UM backup using snapshots can be done quite easily. Before configuring ActiveIQ Unified Manager for snapshot-based backup and restore for Windows, a few pre-configurations must be done on both ONTAP storage and Windows host machine. Configure an iSCSI-enabled storage VM and set up a volume that has appropriate capacity and a single LUN. Ensure that the volume is dedicated only for this LUN and the appropriate iGroups are set. Discover the LUN configured on the Windows machine and configure a new drive. Now let's go ahead and set up snapshot-based backup on iSCSI LUNs on Windows machine. Open the Windows PowerShell command utility and run the command maintenance console. From the main menu, choose option 4, Backup Restore. Now from the Backup and Restore menu, choose option 2, Backup and Restore using NetApp Snapshots. From this menu, choose option 1, Configure NetApp Snapshot Backup. Now under Snapshot Backup Configuration using LUN menu, choose option 1, Enter Backup Configuration Details. Now you will be prompted to give in Unified Manager username and password. Once the login to CLI is successful, it will prompt you to give pre-configured backup details. Now the process will prompt you to confirm if you have mounted the LUN on the Windows host machine. Press Y to confirm. Enter the mount path where the LUN is configured as a new drive. The user will be asked to confirm if the information given is correct. Once the connection is successfully established with the cluster, it'll make sure that there is sufficient space as per the backup recommendations. Then the console will list operations that will be done to configure the backup, and it'll also ask the user for confirmation on the upcoming operations. Enter Y to confirm. Now the snapshot-based backup configuration workflow will proceed and end gracefully. Now let's go ahead and check the backup settings page and confirm if the backup method is snapshot-based. The database backup page UI under the General tab will display the snapshot copies taken as per the schedule or on demand. It is also possible to change the retention count for the snapshot copies by configuring the retention settings under Backup Settings. Here, you can set the backup schedule to daily, weekly, or none.